Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel. I hope you are enjoying the videos. For more insight on HR practices and real corporate world exposure, please subscribe to our channel, like the video and do share it with others. Also, please press the bell icon to never miss an update from HR Success Talk. Thanks a lot. Enjoy this video.
Hi everyone, I'm Monica Marwa. I'm part of NCR Corporation managing as a role of university hiring leader. Here, with my exposure of university hiring from last close to 10 years, I thought I'll be able to share some basic ideas about how to create a unique university hiring program while you start building onto it. And it is important that you invest properly year on year for that particular perspective. So let me just quickly share my screen. Let me just let you know on what is the process we're gonna follow and how are we literally redefining our entire university recruitment process. So while we thought about redefining this process, it is important for us to know why do we really hire fresher from a TA perspective, from a talent acquisition perspective. It is important for us to assess the benefit of hiring these resources. Before we get into these conversation, I'm going to touch base on why we hire freshers, what are the purpose of hiring these freshers. Then what's changing in university relations? What's changing? Why do we think it is important for evolving the new program altogether? What are the best practices we should be looking at? Why we hire freshers from the industry? What is a kind of a snippet of an internship program? Well, what we can quickly formalize? And the last one is RACI. Have you heard about this word, like responsibility, accountability, and confirmation and identification of the roles and responsibility of individuals? Do we really require that in university hiring or not? So let's hear it across. Now, before we get into that, let's see the talent acquisition as a group itself. So now the entire talent acquisition is evolving. We have business strategies being playing into the picture. We have talent strategies, which is resulting into talent business results altogether. So that is the only reason we have a proper planning and strategies. We do a stakeholder management, compliances, recruitment, advisory, analytics, ATS, outsourcing, but the important thing is employer branding. And one of the core competent out of this talent acquisition group is university relations. And that's what I'm here to touch base upon. That's what I'll run you through more about it. So moving with that, why organizations really hire fresher? So basically, these are the key pointers which we really feel that hiring fresher is important for an organization because, yes, we save a lot of money because at times we can modify our hiring process in a manner that there's a different compensation curve they look up for. That is the reason we pay them a little differentiated compensation. At par, there are a few roles which we are paying more as well, but those are bringing a unique product learning altogether. Plus, they bring in a fresh outlook for all the positions which we cater to. They are adaptable in nature. They are open to explore and innovate. They bring in a lot of competitive backgrounds. You know, they come up from a different skills, different backgrounds where they are able to practice a lot of practical implications in the organization. And yes, they are key learner. You know, we are able to mold them as per our requirement, as per our business strategies. And they are definitely multitaskers because they know how to make the fun in life, how to make sure they learn a new skills, how to make sure they are able to present themselves, how good they are into communication. So in and all, this is all comprising a good building a TA strategy, which helps us ensuring a strong foundation for any organization. So it gives a good structure to our hiring hierarchy because this gives us a strong baseline. When we have a stronger baseline, we are able to have more better returns in the future in terms of our revenue of the organization. So that is the reason organizations spend a lot of money and efforts in hiring freshers. So what's changing right now? We've been talking about university hiring from ages. What's new right now? So if I talk about newer version of this university domain, is basically three things which is coming up. We have a lot of diversity and inclusion talk on the town because right now we are talking about hiring differently abled people, hiring different genders altogether, open for all. There is no biases, coming out of the biases and making an inclusive environment for the people. And you know, if from a fresher's hiring perspective, if we build that strong foundation, we are able to have a stronger outlook for the organization. along with that, there are a lot of new features which has come up in the industry from an AI perspective. When I talk about artificial intelligence perspective, like sourcing, screening tools, online assessments, evaluation processes, puzzles, so and so forth. So everything is pretty unique right now, which is creating an portfolio. Third one is early talent programs. When we say early talent programs, these are the programs which most of the organizations are investing strongly altogether. Why is that? Is because we are making sure these programs cultivate a culture of togetherness, culture of bringing the synergy into the people. And that is something which is really helping us building a strong future for newer generation. What are the best practices in hiring freshers? Is first and foremost, we need to be consistent, commit what we can really sustain in the future. Stay updated with the latest technologies because freshers are updated with the technologies and they want you to be the same. Pre-placement talk marks a very strong impression for you. So make sure that you are properly ready. You have a stronger employer branding presentations where you are able to connect with them. Be innovative. While talking to them, while building a new goodies program, find some creative ways to attract. That is something which is very, very important. Spice up your boring job description. They are not looking out for that detailed conversation. Figure out what's new, what it is they are going to do it in the organization. Better connect with the placement coordinators, really help you get a right timing in the organization that, yes, this is the time when you need to visit the campus, get the first ranking, 0-day ranking altogether. That's only possible with a better networking. Online assessments are the new game changers because that's really helping us evaluate and shorten our process of screening. It's very important to have a stronger interview tips that, yes, you need to have a one-on-one connect with the freshers. You're not asking for any specific skills, but you are actually looking forward in evaluating an attitude and an aptitude of a person and an EQ of a person. That can only be evaluated through a one-on-one discussions. Create unique questions, which can help you differentiate one person from another. There should not be a repetitive responses. Having build a very good connect with the students, that's very, very important. Make them comfortable initially. And finally, create an experience for them. They should feel that we miss this opportunity rather than fine, it's just another organization. When we say internship program, it is important for us to create a transformation journey for any entry-level program. We have to build a very transparent and a robust program altogether. How we do that? It's like we plan in terms of having a proper training, experience, making a competent atmosphere, learning atmosphere, which will help them get a knowledge, which will ultimately nurture them to grow in the organization. So what do we do is we identify the right set of organizations, universities we cater to hire from. Then we define the tenure. It's 2 months, 4 months, 6 months duration of an internship we look up for. It is important to allocate mentors for these people because they need a support guidance initially to nurture and understand your organization way of working. And last but not the least, you need to make sure that you have a stronger performance review mechanism process. That's very important because that's how you're able to see whether you want to retain these people, they will grow with your profile or not, or you want to modify some changes into it. Last is RACI. This is something new which has come up from a university hiring perspective, and why it came into picture is like, who needs to be involved in university recruitment processes? When it is need to be started? What is the role of a business leader in the process? Who needs to be informed? And where role of university recruitment team ends? These all questions were coming on and off from any organization. So it was important for us to define a proper RACI document. Who's responsible for what? Who is accountable for what? And who needs to be consulted and informed? So this really helps us define the entire university program from a demand forecasting to identification of universities to creation of an offer to finally defining who's going to do what and finally doing a stronger employer branding. All these steps comprise the entire university recruitment process. That itself creates a unique USP for you as a recruiter, as a talent acquisition professional or a university recruiter. So create your own domain. That's very, very important. At the end, I would say old ways won't open new doors. You have to create a new ways to it and make sure you create your own unique USP, which differentiates you as an individual from anybody else. So that's it from me. Thank you so much, Monica Marwa. And thank you so much for your time and listening to me.